How's it, guys and girls? We are back on the farm again today, and as you can hear, the wind is a bit crappy again today, but we are not going to talk a lot. We are going to shoot a lot, but just a quick introduction. We are going to use the 177 Delta Wolf again today with the immersive optics and the new Scopemate NVS 90. If you haven't watched the review on the Scopemate, please click the link up here somewhere and check it out. It is a really nice product. But let's stop talking and let's get into the shooting. So sit back, relax and enjoy. First dive down at 30 meters. 177 Delta Wolf in the wind. So let's carry on. What a brilliant shot! That was at about 44 meters. I know it's really not far, but with the 177 in this wind, honestly, it's much more difficult than you think. Sparrow. I'm not sure about the ranges, I'm not really going to call it out too much. It really takes too long to range and record or press record. Oops. Got another dove. I suppose the ranges should be around anything between, I would say, 20 to 30 meters. It's really not far, but today the farm foreman actually asked me to get into these feed lots and see how much I can shoot, because I have a problem with the finches, house sparrows and the doves. So they basically crap in the troughs, and the cows get ill, and some of these cows are still calves, very young. So that's why I do what I do today. Tons of fun. So another dove and a house sparrow. Two of these doves came to sit on the fence, and the gun had enough power to penetrate through the first one and hit the second one as well, so I got a double there, but luckily it's close enough to get a follow-up shot. So as you guys can see from the last hunting video that I've made, this scope mate is not a bad device. You just lose a ton of field of view. And I would honestly like them to change the 16mm lens either to a 14 or 12mm lens to get the most out of this this scope, and just do something about this record button. It really takes so much time to hold it in for 1 second right on top here. By the time you want to shoot, you know, the stuff that you want to shoot is gone. It's not like with the GoPro, I just press a button and it starts recording instantaneously. So it's not a train smash, but I would like things to be smoother and much faster. I mean, it's hunting, you don't really have tons of time when you want to take shots. You have to be very quick sometimes. Well, that was a cracking shot. I suppose it's out to 50 meters plus. I decided to come and sit here in one of the middle feed lots here. You know, walking around in that other area was just not as successful as I wanted it to be. As soon as I started walking up to them, they would have, you know, just decided to fly off. So here I can actually sit and have a better area to shoot at, and there's less livestock in the way. So I just, you know, take away the risk of maybe, you know, shooting into one of the cows or so. I have a better, I actually have better control here of my shooting conditions. So yeah, that was a perfect shot. Well, there's a crow taking my my dove. This one's sitting closer. Let's see. That was a solid shot. The wind is so bad, as soon as that dove fell, it just moved to the side. So cracking shot. Just wanna film that crow again. Not something you see every day. Really nice. Oh, it's coming towards this one. Around like a boss here. Really nice. Love to see stuff like this in nature. smoked him.
So this is where my journey ends for today, so be sure to hit that subscribe button with the bell notification so you can be notified with all the upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Cheers!